Gustavus Adolphus, King of Sweden, rose to power on October 30th, 1611, and died leading a charge in a battle on November 6, 1632. He had a large impact on modern Sweden's territory and many military ideas of the future. He was born in the city of Stockholm in Sweden on December 9, 1594, under the House of Vasa, and his father, former king Charles IX. His kingship started in a very troublesome time for Sweden, which happened to be at or close to war with three different countries. Even after those wars, he had a battle in the 30 Years' War against the German Catholic League and the mighty Holy Roman Empire. Gustav Adolf had a very different way of battling that was very effective against the enemies he fought. Gustav's strategy was a very mobile and aggressive one. His idea was an adaptation of the pike and shot system used by the Dutch during their war for independence in Spain. The system split infantry regiments into two units of 500 men. The men were commonly put into three squadrons of arrowhead formations. Occasionally, there was four squads put in a diamond formation. Gustav originally used these tactics to compensate for Sweden's bad horses. The formation were six men deep of pike central block, flanked by musketeers. When enemies would come near, the back three lines would move up and form a thick three-man line, with the first line kneeling, second line crouching, and the third line standing. All these lines would fire simultaneously to break the enemy's ranks. When the musketeers needed to reload, they would take cover behind the pikemen in the front. When the enemy formation faltered, the Swedish infantry would charge into melee combat and catch the enemy off their guard. The part that made the formations even stronger was the use of light artillery like 3-pound cannons, which were very mobile and they could move with the infantry. There were up to 12 cannons with each brigade of men. Gustav had a very different way of using cavalry that worked very well against other cavalry. He would reorganize his cavalry into two squads, with each squad comprising four companies of 125 men. The part that really separated his cavalry from others is that he placed platoons of 50 musketeers within the cavalry. So when the enemy cavalry charged, musketeers would fire and break the ranks of the opposing line.
Welcome to Vietnam!
This upcoming video will explain Gustavus Adolphus's battle tactics more in depth than I have.
Thank you.
Thirty Years' War, which started in 1618 and ended in 1648, was about Protestant and Catholic faiths breaking away from each other in the Holy Roman Empire. As the war went on, it became less and less about religion, and more about the France-Habsburg rivalry, and many powers in Europe were getting involved. When Ferdinand only let Catholicism be worshipped, that's when the empire started to fragment and go to war with itself, and that's when other countries started to get involved for all different types of reasons. People had different theories about why Sweden joined the war. Some people think it's because of religion, but others think that Sweden just wanted to claim all the Baltic Sea to monopolize the Russia-West Europe trade routes. I personally think Gustavus had both ideas in mind when he went into war. He wanted his religion to spread and his home to grow and prosper. This would have been the good economical choice for Sweden, would have been all of the resources from the province they hold to trade along their monopolized trade route, while at the same time spreading Lutheranism. While Gustavus first entered the war, he had no allies whatsoever helping him in the conflict, but soon after joining did he ally with Saxony. During the war, Gustavus had many victories, one of the greatest being the Battle of Brandfield, where Gustavus beat the Catholics even after his allies from Saxony fled. Although sadly enough, Gustavus Adolphus wasn't able to fight for much longer, as he died a little over a year later while charging in a battle at the Battle of Lutzen. Gustav Adolf was buried at Ritterholm Church in Stockholm, Sweden, on June 22, 1634. In Sweden, Estonia, and Finland, there is a day dedicated to Gustavus Adolphus called Gustavus Adolphus Day, which is on November 6th, the day he died, which is usually celebrated with Gustavus Adolphus pastry. There are also several city squares throughout Sweden dedicated to him, like in Stockholm and in Gothenburg. Gustav also had an effect in shaping Europe through his new battle ideas, for he was studied by leaders like Napoleon and Karl von Clausewitz, which they adapted to help them in their battles throughout their war.
Captain Gars kommer att bli mycket glad över att ge sig ut i krig igen.